Hello YouTube family, welcome back again onto my channel Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. Back again on the road. Apparently we've got just one job tonight. Did all my checks as usual. If you're new to this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my contents. Go to my YouTube channel and check out the Sheppey Run. Check out Sheppey, and we're heading to Sheppey tonight. Everything is all sorted out, got all my checks done, and we're on the road already. So if you want to know more about trucking, go to my channel and check it out. I'll be updating you as we go along. To make things easier for me today, I decided to take a different route that we normally do use it, because if you're trying to get away from traffic and all the commotions, always take the A14, M11, then get back onto the M25, go over the Dartford crossing, and then head to Sheppey via the M2. Right, I've also downloaded a couple of videos regarding the Dartford crossing, over the Dartford crossing and through the tunnels. So you can always go on and check it out yourself onto my channel. I'll be updating you as we go along. If there's any updates, I'll give you a shout. See you guys in a bit. Right guys, so far so good guys. Welcome back again to my channel. ETA is going to be 22-24. Try our best to get there before our 6-hour deadline. And clear the 6-hour route. Just before we start offloading, that could be good enough for us. And then offload, after offloading, have a break, and then drive down. It will all depend with the traffic, road closures, because on the M25 there's always road closures, always, and there's diversions. So keep you updating each and every update that will be coming along. So the good thing with this road is everything is always smooth, and there's not much traffic unless there's a breakdown on this particular road, and then you know you've got no way out. You've got to wait until the blocking you on this road is being recovered. So because unless you're near to a junction, then you can just go off and either turn around or look for an alternative route. But it's always a good route to take. So guys, I'll speak to you later on. See you guys in a bit. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again to my YouTube channel Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. We're just leaving the M14, picking up the M11 towards Stansted, heading to Sheppey. We'll be going off the M11 to join the M25 in a couple of minutes. But so far so good, everything is running smooth, no commotions, no updates as yet, and hopefully we'll be in Sheppey at 22-26 now. 2 minutes have gone on top. So that's the ETA, and it's going to help us to get our 6 hour rule, 15 minutes done in time, and then get on with the offloading, and then after that have a break and then drive down. Yeah, it's a pity today that we've got to go and do this short run, because one of my friends was not trained to get his load tipped at Sheffield, because you need to be trained to use the machines to get the load off. So just given my job that I was supposed to do today, Cardiff for the FAI, but it's all right. It's going to be an early shift today, and then try and rest for the rest of the 3 days. I'm not doing any extras this time. I'm just going to do this last shift tonight, and then concentrate on the other videos that I'll be posting on my channel. So guys, I'll update you as soon as we approach the M25. If there's any updates, I'll give you a shout. See you guys in a bit. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again onto this channel, Truckers Lifestyle, at our friend's YouTube channel. We're soon approaching Stansted Airport. Just passing by, and most holiday travelers use Stansted Airport. It really accommodates quite a number of flights that go around Eastern Europe, Western Europe, and almost everywhere. Yeah, we'll be just passing by. Almost getting to M25. So far so good. Quite a number of aeroplanes are crossing over. It's just that I haven't seen any which is landing. Most of the time we always get the chance to get to film at least one trying to land. They always land every couple of minutes. Yeah, so far so good, guys. Almost getting to M25, and then ETA is going to be the same. Oh, there's one taking off, I think. Yeah, it's just taking off from the far end. You can just see it's just taking off. You can see the lights there. Yeah, so far so good. Let's see how we get on. Not much of any updates so far. It's just that we just have the normal traffic today. Being a weekday, I thought it would be a bit busy, but it's looks good. Looks really, really good. Especially when you are on this side of the, you know, of the M25. So I guess the M1, M25 must have been chock-a-block. I'm not really sure, but I think so. But it's always quiet this end. You know, the traffic flow is so nice. And you don't need to worry all the time that, you know, you're going today. Right, guys, I'll update you once we get closer to the M25, which is not far off. But as we speak now, just crossing the junction that's that takes you to Stansted Airport, and on my left is where you have all the car park, thousands and thousands of cars parked there. People leave their cars there, then travel abroad, take their flights home, then come back, pick up their cars and drive off to wherever they're going, to their homes. Right guys, I won't bore you more, so I just let you go and keep you updated. See you guys in a bit. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again to my channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. We are descending now from the M11. We're going to join up M25 soon. So far so good. It's been a good ride. No issues whatsoever. And hopefully we're going to get there on time. ETA has gone up a bit by a minute, so it's 22:27. So all the same, it's still okay. So let's see how we can get on to get to Sheppey. Most of the times when you get there, there's a very, very long queue trying to join the M25. But today's quiet, which means everything is okay. So I hope the M25 is good. Let's see how we get to get onto the M25. It looks quiet, I can see it from here. Right guys, speak to you once we pick up the M25. Right, YouTube family, welcome back again. We are on the M25 now. On the M25. Looks to be quiet. And, I don't think there's any commotions on the way, but we'll find out. So far, so good. So, let's just see how things materialize. Somebody's broken down on the hard shoulder. Right. Yeah, so keep you updated guys, see you in a bit. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again onto my channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. We are heading heading to the Dartford crossing guys. If you're new onto this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my content, and try and see how the Dartford crossing is. I've put this video before and I'm going to post it again guys. We are going to cross the Dartford crossing. Farther ahead you can see the bridge, and I'm going to try and see that we cross over gently as normal. It's a 50 mile an hour on this bridge, but some people tend to go slow and some tend to go very fast, but we try to keep the speed up to 50. This is the Queen Elizabeth Second Bridge, 1991. It's so amazing the way this bridge was built, guys. It's the Dartford crossing. When you're going down south, you go over the bridge, and when you're coming back north, you go under the bridge, and there are two tunnels underneath the water. Tunnels, one is for the hire trailer, the one on the right while when you're coming back, and the one on the left is for the lower trailer. It's a 15.6 I guess, 15. I'll put it down on the comments because I always do forget about the height. So yeah, it's amazing the way this bridge was built up. It's got all this sustainable cables that hold the bridge and to keep it, you know, in one place, especially in the middle where you got ships crossing over onto the other side to do the delivery. You got fuel tankers on the left down below where they put all the fuel there in those tanks, and then afterwards to supply the fuel to the gas stations. And on our way back, I'll try and see that we record the tunnels again. You always have fuel tankers waiting on the left side for the escort to be escorted through the tunnels. They always wait for a number of them. It depends how many the escorts want to, you know, to take over. Right now I can just see only two, but I think they always wait until the number gets to more than five, and then they escort them through the tunnel. Yeah, what comes up always goes down. So now we're descending, getting off the bridge. We'll be picking up the M2, which is going to take us straight to towards Sheppey, whereby we're going to pick the 249. That's going to take us straight to our delivery point. So far so good, everything is running smooth, and traffic seems to be quiet. I've never seen it so quiet like this before. And both tunnels look to be, one is closed. I can see the signs on the way back. One is closed, and most of the time it's one of them. I can't tell which is which, but I think it's the left one. The lower tunnel, which is left. So if it is closed, even the tankers have to use the right one. So once they're escorting the tankers, they always block the road. The escorts, they always block the road leading to the tunnels until they escort the fuel tankers across. Once they've escorted them across, then they release the other traffic. So we'll see when we get back on our way, but I'm pretty sure I've seen signs the left tunnel is closed. So let's carry on with our journey, and I'm gonna go off at this junction and pick up the M2, which is gonna take us up to junction four, and then we'll go off and pick up the 249. Right guys, we'll be just going off here. Good enough, it is open. This is going to take us all the way on the M2 towards junction 4. That's where we're going to be going off at junction 4 on the M2. Right guys, I'll keep you updated as we go along. If there's any updates, I'll give you a shout. See you guys in a bit. Hello YouTube channel, welcome back again onto Truckers Lifestyle, our YouTube family. We're almost getting off the M2 at junction 4. Going off at junction 4, and then pick up the 249, which is going to take us to Sheppey. ETA is as I thought, but it's gone up a bit, 22.29. And it's quite a good time getting there before our 6 hour. So I have to get that 6 hour out of the way before we start unloading, and then do the unloading, have a break, and then turn and burn rubber back to base. So there's not been any commotions, everything's been smooth, traffic has been good enough, and roughly we'll be taking some coverage of the Dartford crossing. I'll just have to add it on there, and then see what to do next. Yeah, so let's get that offload, have a break, and then think about coming back home. Yeah, so far so good, guys. It's not far off. I'm just going to go off at the junction now for it's five, junction five. Sorry, guys. My apologies. It always goes off my mind. It's junction five. So you just go off junction five. M2, you just go off junction 5 and then pick up the A249. Right, guys, we are just going off, trying to follow this other truck which is ahead of us. I think if I'm not wrong, it was a Morrison, I guess. It takes the same route, Morrison Depot somewhere. A249 down the bottom. It's nice and easy. It's a slow bend, so we have to be careful while going down. Right, guys, so I'll give you a shout when get to the gatehouse. So we're just gonna pick up there you go, that's a Morrison. This is another Morrison. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I saw this truck's coming down this side. Yeah, so there's a very big massive depot, Sittingbourne, in Sittingbourne. You've got a big massive depot for Morrison's. Right, guys, we are on the 249. I'll give you a shot once we get to the gatehouse. See you guys in a bit. That's how we get off the M2, come under this long massive bridge. We've got all the M2 crossing over. Right, guys, see you in a bit. Roadblocks, guys, before you get to Sheppey. They're doing some construction roadworks along here until I think just near the Sheppey Bridge. Yeah, we'll just go over that Sheppey Bridge together so that you see it. Most of the times when it's windy, it's not safe to, especially if you have a curtain, to drive over. So most of the times we use the other route down the bridge. There's another route that was designed, the old road, in fact, before they built the Sheppey Bridge. So just going through this. This time it's open. The other time we had to go left and then go over the top at the roundabout and then go back onto the A429. Well, this time it's opened up this side, so which means we're trying to clear off a couple of things to get this the building up in another region to cross over. Right, guys, that's 50 mile per hour here. It's a controlled speed, and let's see how we get to the Sheppey Bridge. Right, guys, we are on top of the bridge. Somebody else has gone underneath. Yeah, this is the Sheppey Bridge. Up, 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 and away we go. And then start offloading. Right, I've got to go open up the curtains and then back up on the bay. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again onto my channel, Truckers Lifestyle at Alfredo's YouTube channel. Finally done, finish off loading. I've done my curtains again and just got to go out and have a break and then head back to the yard. So if you're new onto this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my contents. Hit the notification bell to receive more videos regarding truckers lifestyle. I'll try and see if I can get the Dartford tunnel if possible, but apparently I noticed that one of the tunnels is closed. If not, go onto my channel, check out Sheppy and Sheppy Plus One or Sheppy, then you'll see how to get through the Dartford tunnel, or type in Dartford crossing or Dartford tunnel and you'll see my videos. Right guys, ciao for now. Hello YouTube family, welcome back again onto my YouTube channel, Truckers Lifestyle at my friend's YouTube channel. Left tunnel is closed, as I thought so. It's closed and we're going to be using the right one. We're going to be crossing through the tunnel. As I told you before, the left is closed and they always close it for maintenance, and sometimes if they have the fuel tankers waiting to be escorted, they just use the left tunnel. So the left tunnel is 15.9 feet. The height is 15.9, 4.8 meters, and the right one is 16.6, which is the highest tunnel where you can have all the double deckers going through. So it's just a 5.0 meters high. We've got a speed limit. 50 miles per hour, I think, because of changing lanes from one end to the other because of the closure of the left tunnel. So far so good. For those who've not gone through with us into this tunnel, your car, you are welcome to join us. We'll be crossing this tunnel, which is 1 mile long. It's a mile long, and we're gonna be crossing it nice and easy. So, just keeping up to the right speed so that we don't overdo it. And now we're gonna go through the the right tunnel, which is the highest of all, is 16.6 feet, 5 meters. The one on the right is 15.9, which is 4.8 meters high. The tankers are on the right, as you can see, they're waiting for the escort to be escorted through the tunnel. Is set. The Dartford crossing is at the top. Now we're going into the tunnel. It's there's a speed limit, but sometimes it's better to go less speed than going right to the maximum speed that you're allowed to go, just to be on the safe side. I'd rather go a bit less than 5 speed than rushing it. So we'll have to go take it easy. Climbing up. tunnel. It's not busy as it normally is. Sometimes you get, you know, really queue up right to the max. But they're good. So far, so good. Yeah, so that's the end of the tunnel. Up is the Dartford crossing where we passed when we're going down south. And that's it, guys. You can just imagine the way all this was built in a way to make life easy to cross from one end to the other end, because there's waters crossing over. So guys, if you're new to this channel, please kindly do subscribe, share and like my contents. Hit the notification bell to receive more videos regarding Trucker's Lifestyle. I'll be posting this video as soon as I get it edited. And guys, I see you in the next one. Ciao for now.